Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemeds. Today we are discussing about the topic smog. Smog is an air pollution that reduces visibility. There are two types of smog: photochemical smog and London smog. Smog is a term used to describe a mixture of smoke and fog. It is a mixture of air pollutants which is often seen as a dark gray or brown haze hanging in air over industrial areas or busy urban areas. Nowadays, it is a very common air pollution. Firstly, we can discuss about the photochemical smog. It is the haze in the atmosphere accompanied by high levels of ozone and nitrogen oxides caused by the action of sunlight on pollutants. Photochemical smog is also known as Los Angeles smog. Photochemical smog occurs most prominently in urban areas that have large number of automobiles. They are characterized by hot sunny weather. The components of photochemical smog include nitrogen oxides, ozone, formaldehyde, acrolein, peroxyacetyl nitrate, along with a number of volatile organic compounds like aldehydes and ketones. All these are harmful to living organisms. The components of photochemical smog are secondary pollutants produced by the action of sunlight on mixtures of volatile hydrocarbons and nitrogen oxides, which are produced by automobiles, power plants and factories through the combustion of fossil fuels, as well as from the evaporation of solvents and fuels and from burning plant matter. Photochemical smog has a high concentration of oxidizing agents, so and is therefore called oxidizing smog. It is also called Los Angeles type smog in the memory of the terrible smog experienced in Los Angeles in 1944. Nowadays, it occurs in the several regions of the world. Do you know how photochemical smog forms? When fossil fuels are burned, two kinds of pollutants are emitted into the Earth's atmosphere. These are hydrocarbon and nitrogen oxides. At high concentration of nitrogen oxides, a photochemical chain reaction occurs in which NO is converted into NO2. Then NO2 photochemically decomposes into NO and oxygen. NO and free oxygen atom. This reactive oxygen atom combines with oxygen and to form ozone. Ozone oxidizes NO formed in the previous reaction to regenerate brown NO2, which is the major contributor to the brown haze. Both NO2 and ozone are strong oxidizing agents which can react with the unburned hydrocarbons in the polluted air and to produce chemicals such as formaldehyde, acrolein, peroxyacetyl nitrate, along with the various other volatile compounds like aldehydes and ketones. The product stay in the atmosphere and producing smog. Do you know what are the adverse effects of photochemical smog? The main ingredients of photochemical smog are nitrogen oxides and ozone, as well as various volatile organic compounds including formaldehyde, ketones, aldehydes, acrolein, peroxyacetyl nitrate, etc. These pose several health issues to living organisms and are harmful to non-living things. Peroxyacetyl nitrate, ozone and aldehyde components of the smog cause eye irritation and respiratory tract problems. Some of the volatile organic compounds present in the smog are carcinogenic in nature and cause cancer. Nitrogen oxide of the smog irritate nose, throat and lung and can lead to lung cancer. Also, headache, chest pain, acute respiratory diseases like cough, bronchitis, asthma, heart problems, etc. Photochemical smog is also toxic to plants. Higher concentration of NO2 damages the leaves of the plants and retard the growth of a plant by decreasing the rate of photosynthesis. Photochemical smog also leads to cracking of rubber, discoloration of painted surfaces, corrosion of metals, degeneration of stones and building materials, etc. Then, how to control photochemical smog? Do you know? The best method to control the photochemical smog is to control the primary precursors such as nitrogen oxides and hydrocarbons. So the secondary pollutants such as ozone, peroxyacetyl nitrate, etc. will be automatically decreased. For this, usually catalytic converters are employed in automobiles, which prevent the release of nitrogen oxides and hydrocarbons to the atmosphere. Further, some of the ways to reduce nitrogen oxides and volatile organic compounds emission from automobiles are the use of liquefied petroleum gas or CNG, compressed natural gas, rather than petrol and diesel. Decreasing the number of motor vehicles on the road by walking or by using public transport such as buses, train or by carpooling rather than using the individually owned vehicles or by the use of bicycles. Another suggestion is that implementing various engines and emission controls to decrease the release of nitrogen oxides and hydrocarbons to the atmosphere. For example, the use of catalytic converter in the automobiles. Another control method is to reduce the primary pollutants. Another method to control photochemical smog is that reduce the formation of constituents of the smog from the primary pollutants. For this, one method includes spraying of certain chemicals into the atmosphere so as to generate free radicals. These free radicals readily compete with the free radicals responsible for the formation of smog and thereby nullify their effect. Another method is that planting certain plants like pinus, pyrus, which can metabolize nitrogen oxides and can reduce the formation of smog in the atmosphere. These are the various control methods of photochemical smog. This is all about photochemical smog. Next, we can discuss the classical smog. It is also called sulfurous smog or leaden smog. Classical smog or sulfurous smog occurs normally in cool, humid climate and is found to be in dark grey haze in many countries, particularly in winter mornings. It's a mixture of smoke and fog and very high concentration of sulfur oxides. The chemical components present in sulfurous smog are SO2, SO3, sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, sulfuric acid, and NH4, HSO4. Classical smog is a chemically a reducing mixture, so it is called a reducing smog. Due to high content of sulfur dioxide, it is called a reducing smog. What is the reason for classical smog? It is the combustion of industrial and household sulfur containing fuels, that is coal and petroleum, which emits large amounts of sulfur dioxide in the atmosphere. Its formation is also enhanced by the presence of carbonaceous soot and fly ash. It is also called London smog in memory of the terrible smog that experienced in London in 1952 due to the excessive use of coal as a fuel in homes and industries. Do you know what are the adverse effects of a classical smog? Sulfurous smog irritates eyes, throats, lungs and leading to pneumonia, bronchitis and several respiratory diseases, which often leading to pulmonary and cardiovascular diseases. It can also cause lung cancer. Poor visibility condition that occurs due to sulfurous smog creates several motor vehicle accidents. In 1952 December, London City experiences a 5 days sulfurous smog and caused the death of around 4,000 people and also making thousands ill. Many more have died in motor accidents due to the reduced visibility imposed by the smog. Sulfurous smog is also experienced by several cities, for example in Calcutta, Beijing, etc. By controlling the use of sulfur containing fossil fuels, we can control sulfurous smog. Smoke stacks at factories and power plants can help in reducing sulfurous smog. At higher altitudes, winds carry away the pollutants and prevent them from concentrating the smog. This is all about sulfurous smog.